Let's take a look at the second layer now. This thing. What is this about? So this second layer is, as you can see, a stat summary function. So when do you use this? When do you use the stat summary function? Every time you want to plot a statistic. So in a bar chart, you want to plot a statistic because the bars either represent a mean or a median. They don't represent the data. So that means that R has to calculate a statistic to be able to make a bar chart. There are two possibilities. Either you calculate the statistics yourself with the dplyr package, you can. But then it's a lot of work and effort to get them on the plot. You have to do the calculations yourself. And then you also have problems with the fact that you will have a data frame with the statistics and you will have a data frame with the data. And sometimes you want to plot bars and points, yeah, on top of each other. You want to plot bars, but also you want to show the data as points. It means that you would have to use two different data frames in that case, if you want to do that. And it is doable in R, but it's messy. So it's much easier to use this function, the stat summary function, because this thing does everything for you. It calculates the statistics and it plots them behind the screens, and you don't have to do anything. You just have to give him the data, the original data. So that's why I do like the stat summary function a lot. It makes plotting statistics much easier. How does the stat summary function work? Well, it has two very important arguments that you have to set. They are required. And the first one is called fun. And that defines which statistic he needs to calculate and he needs to plot. So for instance, it can be the median. The other required argument is the geom argument. Yeah, and that defines what kind of plot do you want to make. So what you want to do is you want to calculate a median in this example, and you want to put that median in the bars. So you're going to make a bar chart where the bars represent a median. So these two are required, fun and geom. And then you have a whole series of optional arguments like width. So width defines the width of your bars. So when I do this, I run this piece of code, this is what happens. I generate a bar chart, because I asked for it, of this data that was defined in the ggplot function. And my bars represent the median, because that's what I asked here by setting fun equal to median. And the width of my bars is 0.8. So for many of these arguments, these optional arguments, the value that they can take is typically a value between 0 and 1. That's only the case when the x-axis are categories. Because what he assumes when you have categories is that the maximal distance between two categories is 1. So when I do this with 1, with width is equal to 1, I will show you. That's the maximal distance. From that point on, they will start overlapping. So the maximal distance is 1. So for width, you have to set a number between 0 and 1. And that's what I do here. So I don't like this. So I asked here for a width of 0.8. I think the default width is 0.9. So, but that's only true when you have categories on your x-axis. When you would have time points here going from 0 to 20, then that would define the width between your bars. So it depends what kind of axis you have, but in most cases you have a categorical x-axis and then you have to use values between 0 and 1. So, and you see that in the previous example, the first example, here, this one, for instance, I also used the stat summary function, but here, the function that I used was mean. So here I'm creating a bar chart of these data where the bars represent means. So again, when I run this, now my bars do not represent medians, but they represent the mean of every group. And you also see here in this example that when you don't want to plot a statistic, you don't have to use the stat summary function. When you don't want to plot a statistic, but you just want to plot the data, then you use geoms. And I will also come back on that. So for bars, it's pretty easy. It's either a mean or a median. It becomes harder when you think about error bars, but for that, I'm going to first go back to the slides. We have seen this. This is the ggplot function. So we're now here at this stage with the geoms. So I've told you, if you just want to plot the data, you use a geom. If you want to plot a statistic, you have to use this one, the stat summary function. You typically use this one to make bars, because the bars always represent a statistic, and for error bars. Yeah? Error bars also represent statistics. They represent a standard deviation, or they represent a standard error, or they represent a confidence interval. But whatever they represent, it's always statistics. Also for dot plots. In dot plots, your dot also represents a mean or a median. First of all, the stat summary. So it's used to plot statistics, so you have to tell him which statistics. And for that, you have these two arguments. And they are compulsory arguments. You have to define them. Well, you have to define one of the two. Which of the two do you have to define? Well, that depends what you want to do. If you want to calculate one single statistic, like for the bars or for the dots, they represent one thing, a mean or a median. If this is what you want to do, one statistic, you have to set the fun argument. And you set it equal to mean or median. If you have to calculate more than one statistic, like for the error bars, you need to calculate two statistics. You need to know the lower and the upper threshold of your error bar. If you need to calculate two statistics, then you have to set the fun.data argument. Another compulsory argument is the geom. What kind of thing do you want to create? So geom can be bar, it can be error bar, it can be point for a dot plot. And then you have the arguments that are not required, but that you can use to define what you want it to look like. So you can set a fill color for the bars. You can set a color for the dots. You can also set color for bars. What's the difference between the two? Well, fill will define the fill color of the bars, so the color of the center of the bars. And color will define the border color of the bars. For error bars, you can only set color. It's lines. You cannot fill them. You can only color them. And for dots, for dot plots, you can also only set color. You cannot fill points. You have to color them. You can set position, and I will come back on that. You can set shapes. So for the dot, do you want a circle? Do you want a square? Do you want a triangle? That's what shape does. You can set the size. That's in millimeters. So if you want a small dot, you set size to 1. If you want to have a big dot, you set size to 3 or 4. You can set the width. I've already explained when we were in R itself. So for categories, that's the number between 0 and 1. 1 means that the bars are touching each other, and 0 means that you can't see them. And there's also something called alpha that you can set, and that is the transparency. That's also a value between 0 and 1. So, and this is how it works. You have already seen it in action. So, you define the data that you want to plot, you do a plus, and then you add the stat summary function. So, coming back on these two arguments. So, these are compulsory. You have to define them. You have to set them. So, for the fun argument, you either say that it's equal to mean or that it's equal to median. If for some reason you don't want to calculate a statistic, you can set it to identity. Yeah, but in that case, I would use a geom and not a stat summary function. So I never do it. For the fun data, it's a bit more complex. Yeah? You have these values, the ones that you see here. This, this, and this. And this. So these are the different values that you can use for fun.data. This one will plot a confidence interval of 95% confidence interval. Okay. This one will plot a standard error in your error bars. And this one will plot two standard deviations. So by default, if you want to put standard deviations in your error bars, R will take two standard deviations. And essentially, that's the best choice. Yeah, if you plot standard deviations, it makes a lot of sense that you use two standard deviations instead of one. But if for some reason you want to plot one standard deviation instead of two, you will have to add this to your arguments. I will show it in R. It will be more clear when I show it. Median high low will plot percentiles. But here, the default choice is very strange. He will plot these percentiles. Yeah, I know why he does it, but it's not the best choice. So if you want your error bars to be an interquartile range, yeah, your data is not normally distributed, so you want a bar chart with medians, and the error bars are interquartile ranges, you have to use this value for fun.data, but you will have to add this to the list of arguments. But again, I will show it. It will become more clear. So how does it work concretely? You have your ggplot function. You do plus. You add your stat summary function. And you say, for instance, fun is equal to mean. This is an old slide, so it has to be fun. It used to be fun.y, but they changed the name to fun. So this has to be fun. It's a typo. Fun is equal to mean. And then you have the geom argument, and the geom argument is also compulsory. You have to set it. What are the values that you take here? Well, either bar, and then it will produce a bar chart, or error bar, and then it produces error bars, or point, and then it produces a dot plot. Yeah? So how does it work? Inside the stat summary function, you define a geom that is equal to bar. Okay, I will show in R and it will become more clear. So, it is not that hard except for the error bars. That's the hardest part. So, suppose you want to make a bar chart and you want to add error bars to your bars. How to do this? Well, simple. You start with your ggplot, as always. That's the first thing. You define what you want to plot. What on the x, what on the y-axis. Then, plus. And then you add your bars. How? With a stat summary function. You say here, I want to plot bars. The bars should represent a mean, and I'm going to set the width of my bars. So this alone will make the bar chart. And every bar represents the mean of this group. Now, how to add error bars? Well, very simple. You just add another layer. So plus, and then another stat summary, but now one for the error bars. So what's the difference? Well, you want error bars, so geom should be equal to error bar. And then you have to tell him what the error bars should represent, which statistic. So we're going to go for this one here. It's in the slides also. When you set fun data equal to this, it means that you're going to use 95% confidence intervals. And then you can also set all the additional stuff. So you can also set a width here. Yeah. So when I run the whole thing here now, I get a plot with bars and error bars. The bars represent means, the error bars represent 95% confidence intervals.